Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome. I'm Evil Squeegee, and everybody is going to start hearing me double in a second here. Pow! Welcome! Alright, I am here, I am live. This is Everdeep, D&D 5e game. If you are not familiar with Everdeep, this is the first time watching, do not worry. You do not have to have caught any previous episodes. Every episode of Everdeep is its own standalone one-shot adventure. And all you need to do is sit back and watch, complete with house rules, lore, everything. Because I will deliver unto you an amazing game of Dungeons & Dragons on a platter made of silver, unless you happen to be Hawthorne, in which case that might not be appreciated. I'm Evil Squeegee. Today we've got Imagining Mystic. Say hi!
Hi!
Where can they find you?
I almost forgot about Push-to-Talk.
Where can they find you?
Oh, we're doing that now? Okay, they can find me on youtube.com/imaginingmystic, and I do sim stuff. And I also have my own website, which is simslegacychallenge.com.
Donables, what the fuck is wrong with your hair?
I cut it, just like Grizzly. Hi.
Who are you?
I'm Donable. You can find me on the Nerdhub Discord, mainly hanging out sometimes. And on here.
Take back!
Hi. I'm here most days of the week, co-hosting, doing map shit, playing in games, and looking amazing with my beard when Sam's not around to be able to look amazing for me.
And Distracted Elf! Welcome back.
Hello, I'm Distracted Elf. I am a Twitch streamer, and I show up occasionally to punch things.
Alright, you are on your, this is your second time in, isn't it?
Yes.
All right, so you should all be very happy to learn that I have, since our last time playing, shortened the fuck out of our introduction speech. So, without further ado, I know, right? Let's set the tone here and get right into the gameplay, because that is what we do. In the world of ages past, long ago, giants enslaved all the races of the earth. Even the mythical dragons and the gods were bound by them. Each of the race's respective gods were unwilling taskmasters, slave-driving goblinoids and men as the giants wished. The gods themselves were taskmastered by Abaddon and Metatron, brothers and fathers of all godkind. The brothers loved nothing more than one another, and the giants held each hostage, threatening each with the murder of the other, in order to make them keep everyone in line. This changed when one man, an elf whose slave name was Garnash, stole the first bits of magic for his kin. He mastered it in secret, becoming the most terrible wizard ever to have existed. His was a dark and sinister mind, consumed by hatred for giants and dragons who enslaved all the realm. He stopped at nothing with his black magic to bring the race of giants to their knees and overthrew them, casting them from the world with a ritual that cost Metatron his life. This sent Abaddon into a frenzy of madness. But what was done could not be undone. The giants had fallen, men and goblinoids were free, and Metatron was no more. Without the kindness of Metatron to temper him, Abaddon's hatred and thirst for vengeance against all who lived consumed him. He was driven insane, irrevocably evil, and as the most powerful of all the gods, it was his malice which tainted the world, making it demonic and rife with undead, curses, witches, and worse. It is said that his first victims were the elves, which is why they exist no longer. The game of Everdeep doesn't have an expansive, huge campaign world. It has a single village, Everdeep, neighbor to a single adventure site, Everdeep Manor. The manor is thought to have been the Giant King's mansion, later overtaken by the Great Wizard and used for centuries as his tower, laboratory, and library. No one knows how many levels deep the manor digs into the earth, or if it indeed ever ceases descending. It is thought to be the source of all malice in the world, as minor evils constantly lurk on its surface, bubbling up from beneath, driven upward by darker, more horrible things that lair within the deeper levels of the dungeon. The village is small, though the Templar and the Arcane Circle both have an interest in the manor, the former seeking information on the true fate of Metatron, and the latter seeking mystical knowledge for the Great Wizard. This interest in territorial competition means that mercenaries often find themselves hired to delve into the manor. Only the mad, the desperate, or the stupid come here, hoping to make a fortune or carve a name for themselves. Thankfully, in a world without Metatron, there is an abundance of all three of those kinds of people. So, let's start with Grizzly. Race, class, alignment?
Well, race, you see, is a little bit awkward for me because, well, I'm supposed to be a human, but really, you know, well, I'm supposed to be a bear too, but right, no, that's not really right. And then there's, I'm a barbarian, obviously, and there's hair alignment.
Yes.
I'm chaotic neutral, obviously.
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 All right, what about your biography, your likes, and your madness?
Have you ever heard of those people raised by wolves? Those guys are pansies, and they never get enough sleep. You want a real barbarian? You get yourself a barbarian raised by bears. Grizzly isn't my real name. I don't really have one, at least not by civilized standards. People just call me that because, you know, I got to have something. And I'm Area, then the opposite of Zangmax back at what I used to be. Normally, I won't stay in one place for so long, but Mother Bear kept showing me omens of something to come, something I've got to stop for my family of bears.
All right. You were super hairy, and then you got eaten by a gelatinous cube, and now you have no more hair, right?
Right.
He's still a barbarian. He's just bear, as opposed to bear.
Bear, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. What about you, Mystic? Race, class, alignment?
Oh, I like
likes
wine.
And, likes and madness. Yep, you like wine?
I do like wine. A lot of it. Like, if there's wine, I'm going to want it, so be careful. And then my madness, as people call it, I don't know what they're talking about, is something called megalomania. Apparently, I always think I'm right and I'm the best at everything, but I think that's just an excuse for like them being shit. I'm always best, and they're just like, that's a madness. You're not real. It's like, no, I'm actually the best.
Okay, and then we've got Lola, played by Imagining Mystic. Race, class, alignment?
I am Lola, and I am an orc. Sorcerer, also favored soul. And I am neutral good. My likes are natural, wild things, the moon, stuff like that. Dislikes, I don't like civilized things, towns, buildings, schools. I'm actually illiterate because I don't believe in any of that stuff. And my madness is that I am convinced that I have the senses of wild animals, but I don't. And as for my bio, I left home a long time ago. I came from a long line of shamans who allow spirits of the elements to temporarily possess or ride us in order to let those spirits manifest their powers. The spirits speak to me about a lot of things. They are oftentimes selfish things, but that doesn't make them evil. Most recently, the spirits told me I was supposed to run away, and I did. The next day, a necromancer's army wiped out my entire village, my sacred place, and took all of my belongings. And they're still coming. They're coming for me. I thought that maybe if I go to Everdeep, they'll stop following. Nobody in their right mind would go somewhere so dangerous and civilized looking, right? Well, I didn't stop to think that maybe Everdeep would have been worse. The great spider demon Eni almost killed me in the manor, but my party and I defeated her. Now I have two glass orbs that look like baseball-sized abyssal eyes. All the spirits are whispering now about our... Now our...
D6 damage.
I'm doing like really bad today. And I can see through the necromancer's eyes if I meditate on them. He's coming. He's coming to Everdeep. And I have nowhere else to run.
I have a question.
What's up?
Okay. If we're taking D6 damage when we do something wrong in our intro, you're owed about 15 from fucking up your intro. So the first fight get into, you take 16 D6 from your intro as well. I'm happy for this.
As the DM, the DM will take 16 D6. Let's go.
Also, I will refer you to my character sheet where it says I'm immune to Evil Squeegee's bullshit, so I will not be taking D6 damage. It says it on my sheet, therefore it's allowed.
All right, and I don't know if I want to do Zangmak or Elf. Let's do Zangmak because Elf is the guest, so she gets the glory of going last. All right, so Hawthorne, race class alignment.
I am human. I am a Lycan Bloodhunter, Order of the Lycan Bloodhunter, and my alignment is lawful neutral. I was born a noble son. I had it made. Money, women, wine, food, clothes. I never knew my mother. She was slain by a lycanthrope only days after I was born. I idolized her. I practically worshipped the stories they told me about her. Beautiful, blonde, smart, perfect. I studied the arts of blood magic as a young child, keeping my practices secret from my family. Sacrifices of local pets or other people's family heirlooms weren't all that bad, considering the other possibilities. All I needed was a chance to learn to bring back the dead. But I started small. Patience is a virtue, after all. I would often go to my mother's grave when no one was looking and cry angrily at the life I could have lived. A life with her. I practiced my magic there, in the comfort of her presence, where my mind was clear. I'd been working on a rite that would let me contact Mother, and that night I was making my one and only attempt at performing it. The sacrifice the demons desired for this act of magic was something I had, but I could not replicate. I was, however, interrupted by a werewolf. The very beast that had taken my mother from me. I don't remember much about that night. All I know is that in the struggle, I was bitten. And the dark magics I unleashed scared that werewolf away. It was too late, though. I was one of them. I was one of the monsters. I tracked that monstrosity down to Everdeep Manor. I will hunt it and I will kill it. It took my mother from me, and it took away my only chance to see her after that. I don't care that it took away my chances at living a normal noble's life. I want it dead. that really fucks my throat up every time. I will do. All right, let's go with this. He likes everything in its place, everything in its time, organization, cleanliness, and calm thinking. There's no need to panic. Madness is obsession. What would Mother think if I did this or that? What would she say? I wonder what Mother would look like in that there painting.
That's Hawthorne. Now Hawthorne is using the Bloodhunter homebrew class. Matt Mercer designed that one?
Yep.
Yep. All right.
Yep.
And Distracted Elf, race class alignment.
Why, hello. I am Distracted Elf. Well, my character is the Fist. Name the Fist. Race the Fist. Story the Fist. Alignment, chaotic fist.
Well played. That was beautiful.
No, but seriously,
how long have you been waiting to say that?
I've been preparing. dwarf, chaotic good, and her story. Is of course, nobody knows my real name. They just call me the Fist. I'll give you two guesses why. A left guess and a right guess.
And a push to talk button. Yeah.
When I came of age, my older brothers were all sneering at me. The dwarven rite of passage in my home city involved sleeping in pitch blackness of the unnatural depths, and not everyone survived. I don't remember what happened that night in the black and evil cave, but the Fist remembers. Whatever it was, the Fist kicked someone's ass. Badly. Ever since then, I've had this weird fascination with getting in Everdeep Manor. It's so interesting. Also, people are willing to pay me with ale and coin, and since the Fist has already been down to the bottom and come back out, it's fine. It's fine. No, joking. Since the fist is just dumb enough to head inside.
All right, likes and madness.
Fist likes the manor, and doing things in the manor. I don't have dislikes. Madness. madness is. I tell a lot of stories. Some of them are true. Some of them are not. But you can judge for yourself which is which.
The fist talks about the fist as the fist wishes.
Can I just say, Grizzly being told stories? That's going to be interesting.
Oh, yeah, no. Grizzly and the fist in the same part is going to be hilarious. Let's put the tall tale Chuck Norris, the walking Chuck Norris joke in a group with the megalomaniac who has to be better than everybody. This is going to be fucking ridiculous. All right. So, before we get going now, the fist, when we last left you, you had ventured deeper into the manor instead of leaving. And so you went on a solo mission to go fist things.
Yes. That is what I would say as well, Squeegee. Exactly those words, because any other words are unfistly.
Unfistly? What does that even mean?
If I have to explain it, you don't deserve to understand it. The fist says, as the fist wishes.
And
I may be a little bit too in character already.
It's good to know that you enjoy your character.
I have to like start riffing, otherwise I won't come up with anything while we're actually like when I need to do something.
I think I have enough prepped for a short adventure today, so riff away. We're not on a huge time concern. Okay, so
wait, is the fist male or female? Because I hear fist female. And I think guy.
She's,
okay.
She's female. She's a female dwarf.
What's the matter, Mystic? You don't think girls could be badass punch things?
Well,
can be badass punch things.
Shut up! All right.
I'm definitely a badass punch thing.
I don't know. See, like, if I were to try to do it, I'd probably just derp and punch myself. So,
it's,
you know.
It is hard to, like, make the voice of the fist sound like a female dwarf. So, you know, she's a female dwarf, but mostly she's fist gendered. Yeah.
Okay, I'm just gonna, yeah. Fist gendered.
The fist sexually identifies as the fist.
Yeah. As Noel said in chat, that works for me.
Alright, so, okay, so, in Everdeep, each episode is its own standalone. However, between episodes, I do run, consistent vendors. Anybody here who's played Skyrim knows exactly what I'm talking about. I track coin totals, inventories, between adventures I roll to see about other mercenaries, see if anybody bought or sold anything. The inventories or coin totals might fluctuate ever so slightly. They might acquire new magic items, etc. And also, since our last episode, there is a brand new vendor, all right? So I'm gonna take our, stream on a merry little trip here down to the town, all right? The little village of Everdeep, okay? There's the Templar Chapel, which is a tiny little structure with an ever-dwindling number of acolytes who act as the go-between for the gods and man. There is the Arcane Circle over here, which is a series of small tents next to a dead tree. That's where, you know, whatever wizards were batshit enough to come hang out in Everdeep, wound up. And then you've got the Bloody Beard is the tavern. That's the inn of choice. That's where all the mercenaries chill. You got the Gypsy Caravan, which isn't always going to be present. I'm actually gonna be rolling now to see if the Gypsy Caravan is out on journey or not.
Could we get a quick flash of the high scores table for people who are... We have a couple of new people in chat who have never seen Everdeep before.
Yes, we can. Provided I am not a derp. Am I not a derp? I am a derp.
That's my job.
You shut up, derp. We'll get to the high scores. We'll get to the high scores in a minute, all right? Okay. But the new one is the Sanatorium, which is where you go to get your prosthetics if you lose a leg. Or, alternatively, you can get a lot of the healing stuff that the Templar sells, but you can get it cheaper. The downside is that it comes with a risk of infection. You can pay half as much, I think, for it, and risk infection, or you can pay full price and have no risk over the Templar Chapel. Now, where the fuck? Scrub-a-dub, thank you for the follows, guys. I appreciate it. I'm waiting for shit to load on my GM screen. Okay, but while we're here, does anybody have anything they want to do?
I've got a shopping list.
I'm now picturing him with like a little basket and like a list.
There are echoing noises from the manor. You think maybe people getting stomped on by the fist. Other than that.
Alright, so I'm gonna scroll the stream up here. Here are the high scores, alright? Damage dealt in a single round, the highest madness level achieved before death, the most coins achieved before death, the highest experience points earned before death, good karma before death, and bad karma. You know, Snidely is kind of kicking ass all over the board. That is, he is our longest surviving member of the show. And I believe that coming soon will be his last episode, as either he will reach his inner peace or die trying. The way that it works is that as you play along, you will wind up fighting boss monsters. If you defeat a named boss monster and you survive, you get a key item. If you reach 500 coins, you can purchase a key item. If you hit the next level, you get a key item. And when you hit 5 points of good karma, you achieve a key item as well. Each key item expands your backstory a little bit and tells the tale of your character's backstory and unresolved conflicts. And it's not always a happy ending. But that is that. Now, you had a shopping list, you said there, Grizzly.
Yes, I do.
All right, what would you like to shop?
Well, first off, I need to visit the Fancy Dancy Sanatorium to get this leg sorted out.
All right. I know I wrote a price for this. Let me bust out the sanitarium.
Prosthetic is 25 coins.
Yes.
All right, so you want to pay 25 to the sanitarium and roll me a con save?
Of course, but I have a little request as to what the leg would be.
All right.
I just want to make sure it's furry, you know, like a bear's leg.
So you're going to be completely hairless and have just one furry leg?
I'm basically imagining him, he's got basically like a Wookiee's leg from the knee down.
All right. Yeah, so 25 coins and a con save later. Con save, I think, is DC. What did I set it to? No, I set it here. Let me
open up.
Eight. All right. All right, so roll it. Quickly, before somebody can buy you a botch.
I make it.
You make it. All right, so you're down 25. The sanatorium is up 25. Anything else you want to do?
While I'm here at the sanatorium, I need a little something. It's a bit more personal, and you've probably, like, everyone in Everdeep has probably noticed. I want to see if they can heal my hairlessness. Because, you know, like, it's really cold. And if I ever go see Mother Bear again, she probably won't recognize me. I kind of need my hair back.
All right.
Did he have prosthetic fur?
That's exactly what I was thinking. Do you want to pay for that? That'll be a higher DC to avoid infection. It sounds like a very invasive surgery.
I need my head back.
All right. That'll be 25 coins. You see, the guy who runs the sanatorium, or rather, the lady that runs the sanatorium, she is this kind of like hunched over, got thin, beady little eyes, right? And she will do anything she can to score coin, including cut corners, which is why there's an infection risk. So give me a DC 12 con save and blow 25 more coins.
Oh!
Ooh, you lucky son of a bitch. You got exactly 12. Okay, so you will be hairier than you.
Oh, I like it. Thank you very much.
The sanatorium earns its first fan. You have anybody, any other stops? Any other stops you want to make? Do keep in mind the, there are another thing I'm doing is personal scrolls and potions from the Arcane Circle are now randomly rolled each adventure, so those will be changing.
Okay. I picked up a purple potion from last adventure, which we didn't know what it was.
Would you like to? Okay, so you have
but
two
you
options.
You said that I could actually look at it.
You can pay 10 coins to ID the consumable, right? Or you could try it yourself. But if you botch, you're gonna be wrong.
I'll try it myself first.
All right, so roll me your alchemist tools. It was a purple oily potion.
Yes,
that's a potion of lesser restoration.
Oh, okay, cool. I want to also restock on ammo from the blacksmith because I used bullets.
You didn't actually lose any ammunition. Okay, so the ammo rules that we use, we don't actually track each individual shot. Instead,
okay,
you have 2 points of ammunition. Okay, you only lose one, say, on a botch, or if you fall into a water pit, or there's some good reason that you might actually lose your stash of ammo. Right, and as long as you have 1 point of ammunition left, you can still shoot.
Right, okay.
That way, we only worry about ammunition when something happens that might cost you ammunition, other than the shooting itself. We assume you brought enough ammunition for shooting. You don't actually have to restock.
Right, so I don't need to do that. Okay, fine. I'm gonna go to the Bloody Beard for some good stuff.
Alright, the good stuff is available. That's 40 coins to the Bloody Beard, right?
Yeah.
The good stuff is there's this shady looking goblin. Like a long coat that's a little too long, right? And you kinda like walk in and you've got that you scratch your arm a little. Look around suspiciously, and the goblin spies you and he kinda like shuffles over and he says, "Hey! Wanna buy some drug?" And you're like, "Yes, I would love to buy drug from a complete stranger in the Bloody Beard in the middle of Everdeep, where I have no idea what it's made out of."
Sounds like a great plan.
However, that will start you with plus 10 temporary hit points at this adventure. Anything else?
Yep, I want to go to the Templar and call in that favor and cure a level of madness.
All right, done and done. And I think that's the only favor that Hawthorne had, right?
Yep.
Right, I'd like to go to the blacksmith, by the way.
Yep, what would you like?
I'd like her to try and fashion me a, a leather harness of sorts for me to carry all these fancy doodads and knickknacks I'm picking up.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, I've got this fancy little tail whip thing and my shotgun and the mace. I can't carry everything at once, so...
Right, yeah, you want to... Okay, so you want a harness. We'll, Is there any specific way you want it to look?
Maybe like a mankini, so I don't need the loincloth anymore.
Alright, yep. The
mankini?
Helga,
a leather mankini, yeah.
Helga the orcish blacksmith will look at you strangely, but will fill the request for 3 coins, which is a price she seems to pull out of nowhere and be confused about even as she says it. But you can have your mankini.
Oh, this looks awesome.
Anybody else?
I'm disturbed by the image of these straps with, like, hair just, like,
poking out. That's a fucking hair!
One last thing is, I can't seem to see it in the Bloody Beard menu, if you will. Last time I was around... I noted this down as 3 super bloody beard thingy bobby.
That would be.
I rest. Know it was some super.
That would be rest and relaxation. That's the R&R. It was renamed since that adventure. Okay, so that'll give you advantage versus all saves against madness for the day.
Awesome.
And Lola, I believe you had something to do.
Now I don't. Need to be a specific class to buy one of the guns, right? And use it?
You can only use simple weapons. You are not proficient
in
martial weapons.
Okay, I wasn't sure about that.
Actually, wait, no, you are proficient in martial weapons because you're a favored soul! So you can use any gun you want.
Okay. Where's the price listed on here? Because I see the weapons.
The blacksmith. Thing. The blacksmith. It's four times whatever the max damage roll could possibly be. That's how many coins it costs you, and that varies from gun to gun.
I'd like to try and get a pistol. All
right, that's going to be 4 times 8 is 32 coins.
Oh, okay, I can do that.
All right, so you're going to spend those 32. Do remember, you're only lowering the bigger number on your sheet, not the tiny one at the top.
Right. And do I need to buy ammo separately, or does that come
with... It'll come with ammo. Put the number 2 in the red circle over your token.
Okay.
Once we get into the manor. This red circle up here, we're going to scroll up here real quick. This circle up here is ammo, the green one is health, and the blue one is armor class. And Grizzly, you should have 2 ammo, not 5. Okay, so, I believe that is all of the pre-adventure prep and shopping, right?
For the characters, yes, so. But for the viewers, there are a few things that we might need to cover very quickly.
All right, as we're going in here, you can shout BEAT, B-E-A-T, in all caps. That is very important because each player has a BEAT feat, which they can spend their BEATs that you award them, all right? For example, the fist gets a BEAT because it was called by the audience during your biography.
Sweet.
All right.
Charge feet!
So that means you have a second beat, because everybody starts with 1, but only 1. And in order to get more beats to spend to activate their beat feet, then you can, then that is with the audience. It's going to take a whole bunch of you guys in chat calling that. I don't just hand it out because one person said it, alright? Just beat! And then, you could also, you can control the dice, as part of our channel. If you donate, we say thank you. This is your show. This is a show for you. And if you say somebody botches or crits, they botch or crit. The rules for that are all underneath the stream in the Unnatural Dice link and or on that support link right there that says donate to save or kill your favorite NPCs and NPCs. Speaking of which, Zhang, I don't have enough tech difficulties right now. Can't open sheet. So I'm going to rely on you to help me.
Okay. You basically have stuff from Robo ready to go.
That should be piled back off.
Take that away.
Yeah, take that away. Okay. He didn't ask me to put it up this time. So,
okay. Yep.
All right. So, I think that is everything. Oh, also, you can subscribe.
Subscribe and tweet, dude.
Subscribe and the retweet. If we hit 30 retweets today, we're gonna have a giveaway. Secret. All right.
What? Oh, okay. What sort of things could it possibly be?
Well, in the past, we've given away
secret guys.
In the past, we've given away. In the past, we've given away DMGs or monster manuals or players' handbooks or squeegee bunnies.
I still need that, by the way.
I once gave away Sizz.
This is true.
Robovan won that auction. We auctioned Sizz off. It was true. Okay, so with everything there, I think we are good to go. Now, as the story begins, you guys aren't being hired this time to go in. Each of you has your own reason. Lola, with your keen and infallible scent tracking abilities, you smell the necromancer, but not his minions. Just out of sight.
I don't like the smell of this.
Just out of sight. This could be your chance to end it. To gain vengeance.
Yes.
For the death of your family.
Yeah, I agree.
His tracks lead up to Everdeep Manor. Now, that's disconcerting. However, he is evil, so is the manor. There is a great amount of power to be found for the evil in the manor. Perhaps you should stop him before he gets there.
All right, I'm going to ready my gun and start marching off.
All right, Hawthorne. Just out of the corner of your eye, you could have sworn you saw all beautiful blonde woman wearing a white nightgown. Blue eyes that catch the moonlight. Gracefully, just out of sight, ducking into the rubble of the stone and the trees. This is either a trick or your mother. And if it's a trick, somebody's asking for it.
You don't mess with my mother. I'm going after her.
Grizzly! While you are unconscious, getting a full body Rogaine. You have the weirdest dream. It might have just been the drugs that that creepy old doctor lady has you cooked up on. But Mother Bear is in a panic. And she's fleeing into the manor. She needs your help. So after you're done all of your shopping and so on, as if the GM is just railroading you to get the adventure started. Up the manor hill you will go. Now, the manor itself stands on this giant, huge, imposing cliff face with howling wind that might be the moans of the dead, you're never sure. And it weaves, and there are no railings. You can always just look down and see as your feet fall on the dusty path, the rubble and pebbles that kind of like fall endlessly towards the ground, a lethal distance below you. And at the top, there used to be gates at some point, but they long ago fell into decay, much like the forest that surrounds the manor. A giant, imposing building. It was the giant king's mansion. And as such, it's not built for tiny slave races like you. And as you show up, there are two things of import going on. Number one, you are not alone here. There's a man with black hair, goggles strapped to his head, and a formal, if not badass-looking, trench coat. There's a orcish lady with black hair and dark green skin.
Oh, there's Lola. I know Lola.
Oh, yeah, you know Lola. So there's Lola and the new guy that you don't know. And everybody seems to be here for important reason. The other thing you notice is that the manor is on fire. Well, the front of it is on fire. And from within the front doors, you can hear a high-pitched giggling. Demonic in origin, no doubt. And the doors blow open. Unlike before, where every time you came up to the manor, the doors would kind of like creak and swing open as if enticingly, invitingly. This time they blow open the opposite way. As if in panic, as if warning you to run. And a blast of hot air slams into you. You know you can have the skin of your body just exploded right off the surface of yourself from 20 feet away from a fire?
Is it enough to burn hair?
My hair is fine, right?
It's not enough to burn hair. Alright.
Do we all feel this, or is this just Grizzly?
No, this is everybody.
Everybody, okay.
And after, you know, the hot air has subsided, you can hear the crackling of flames. And each of you is certain that which brought you here is going to require you to step inside.
Dun, dun. Ah! Sorry, seemed appropriate.
I know, right? It was also almost perfectly timed with the transition on the map. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to wait for it to load twice. Map is starting to get a little heavy. Thank God we have finally populated all of the manor, the entire map. All right.
Man, on my old computer, this would not load.
All right, so everything is loading here. This is going to take...
Okay, it's fine.
Yep. Everything
I was like,
is...
I can see other things.
Yep, the loading is always a pain in the dick now. We're taking efforts on the second floor of the manor. We have taken precautions to prevent this from happening again. This map is huge, and there is a lot of fog and scorch marks and blood and rubble. And that I'm pretty certain this thing is like 300 megabytes of ping easily.
I would like to say, before I go in, I'm drawing my guns, yep, and I'm doing my right thing as well.
So what does that look
I'm
like?
I'm doing the same thing.
I pull out my pistols and they have like a razor edge on the top. And basically I kind of like rub them against my arms and kind of coat them in blood so that my own blood is actually on these weapons. The weapons themselves, the blood kind of soaks into them and they take on this cold, frosty aura. Like you can see your breath in the air and things like that.
Okay. So, as you enter, all right, there is a giant raging flame to the south and a giant raging flames to the north, right? Now, what winds up happening here is you step into the door, slam shut behind you, not of the manor's own accord. Something else has forced these doors to act like this. Just up on ahead, you will notice a few things. Among the rubble, the dead body that's here, kind of like... on top of and underneath an avalanche of rubble, the stones seem to have been meticulously piled, probably by whoever this poor sap was, in order to give you access to the 30-foot rise. This ledge right here that you guys can see me pointing at both sides of, that is a 30-foot tall cliff. This used to be staircases until it was destroyed, and now somebody seems to have had the idea of creating a ramp that you could climb up with some difficulty. Now... the other thing you'll notice is that the doors just ahead, which have been shackled closed this entire time, they're open. Or one of them is. The entire room, as you step in and you start gaining bearings, your eyes have to adjust to the constantly flickering, rising and lowering levels of illumination. Thick smoke is choking the air. Fire consumes the wood and stone all around you, and everything is kind of permeated with the stench of hellfire and burning flesh. But that's not all. It is at this precise moment that the doors up to the north here will get kicked open, and the fist will come blasting her way out of a room with blood all behind her. Behind you, fist, you will notice the fist has left a path of carnage and destruction.
Can I see them? Because I can't see them.
You can't see the party, no. Do you have vision?
Yeah, I do have vision. Yeah, it's in a line directly south, and there's no players on it.
Yes, your character cannot see them. Yeah, you are seeing what you're supposed to. Behind you, fist, is this pile of bodies, monstrosities, cultists. You even took the time to make the chests and barrels bleed. It is a bloodbath behind you. There has been so much punching. You don't know how you got here. You don't know where you are going. You just know that this was what you were born to do.
Doesn't matter where I am. Doesn't matter where I go. Everything bows to the fist.
I spent
and
about...
if it doesn't bow, I punch it until it bows!
I spent about 30 minutes yesterday building this room for the explicit purpose of giving you a bloodbath of an entry to this adventure.
Some say that the feet of the fist are just more fists.
Alright, so...
He's crazy.
Yes... Grizzly?
I have a question.
I have an answer.
Ooh, cool story. No, Jay. Mechanically, does the prosthetic leg still... Do I still have this...
Half speed, yes.
Half movement and all that?
Yes, you have half movement, and if you don't have the peg leg, or a crutch, or a cane, you can't walk, period.
Okay.
So, as you guys are stepping in, all of this is going on. There is the sound of a door being fisted off of its hinges. but you guys don't see that. You only hear it. The fire and the flames are licking at the walls and the floors, and you can see these tiny little fire demon things just kind of like bouncing around. And they're gonna burp fire as if they expect it to go at you. But it only goes like not at you. Just like, you know, close range, because it's just like a burp. And then they look at each other and they'd be like, and they're gonna start moving in your direction. However, that'll be initiative. Who has the highest initiative modifier in the party?
I have a look.
I got a 2.
I got 3.
Alright, so Hawthorne, roll me your initiative here. I figured out how to do an initiative check with NPCs. Wow, did I botch?
Oh!
Botch. Alright, so, Grizzly, you have the alert feat, and the way that we have written that is that you go first. Fuck it. Because we use sides initiative, which is to say that we go in groups rather than individuals. Every person's turn must begin and end before somebody else's turn can begin, but I don't worry about the order the party goes in. I worry about the order the party as a whole, and then the bad guys as a whole goes in, with the exception of Grizzly, who with the alert feat I have translated to be his own separate faction. So Grizzly, would you like to be a part of the PCs, or would you like to just take the first shot?
I always go first, because I'm the best.
All right, so there's the 30-foot cliff in front of you, okay? It will be a climb check, and it will end your movement. You don't have line of sight to either of those methods, because it's a 30-foot cliff directly in front of you.
Well, I'm going to attempt to climb up the cliff.
All right, roll me athletics. By the way, when we go through, when we enter the door that is open, I need, a 10 will get you up. I need everybody in chat to remind me about bad karma. So this is the end of your movement, Grizzly. Either here or here, your choice.
Can I get up there with 15 foot of movement, though?
I'll let you with the climb check, yeah.
Okay.
Upper body strength.
With your furry peg leg and your new, like, 3 different colors of hair.
As a bonus action, I'll pull out my great axe.
That is also, people who are avid fans of 5th may notice that you're not supposed to spend bonus actions or actions drawing weapons. I have changed that. That is a house rule for welcome to Everdeep. It takes an action or a bonus action to draw your weapons, ready an item. Alright, so! That's Grizzly's turn. Lola, Hawthorne, and the Fist! Does anybody know what they'd like to be doing?
I'm within range of these little fire demons, right?
You can't see them.
Oh, I can't see them.
You're gonna have to go over the cliff. They're above us. Yeah.
All right, then I will climb up and follow Grizzly.
Those stairs, as usual, by the way, Distracted Elf, are difficult terrain. Just so you know. Roll me an athletics check there, Lola.
Okay. Athletics check. You said.
Yep.
Where's that?
On the left-hand side of your sheet, there's a box with all the skills. Athletics is, like, yeah, the second one. Click the word athletics.
I see it. Okay. A 3!
Alright, so your movement is halted here. Would you like to spend an action or bonus action?
I'm still not all the way up on it.
Yeah, you haven't. I am. Like, you're trying to climb up the wall, but it's not working.
I'll spend another action to try to climb.
You don't have another action.
I thought you said a bonus action. Or I don't have that?
No, you failed your attempt to climb up for this round, so you can spend an action or a bonus action to do something else.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't think I still can't fire anything off at the demons, right?
Correct. Roll me perception.
Okay.
Actually, wait, no, you're not looking in there, so that'd be passive perception. What is your perception score? It's the number next to the perception skill.
Yeah, I'm looking, hang on. 1.
Okay, so that would be an 11. Magma bit. Okay, he passes his DC. You don't notice him.
Okay.
So, do you want to cast any spells that take bonus actions? No? All right. Hawthorne, what about you? Hawthorne or the fist?
I mean, we all know my action is going to be punching if I can get there. And I have the charger feet.
And you do have a spare beat.
May be able to get there. The fist will punch the ever-loving crap out of this magma mephit.
Alright, let it rip. I'm almost certain you can reach.
I can, yeah.
Yeah, even with the difficult terrain, if you dash, you're there. And then with a beat feat of charge, you can spend a beat and get an attack at the end of your charge. So,
The fist runs up the stairs, bounds towards the mephit, jumps into the air, and brings one of her already very bloodied fists down onto its head, hopefully. Let's see if all it right. works.
This will also leave you with a bonus action, which you can use for your offhand as well.
Yeah.
Let her rip! Give me that attack, roll
whiff. But I'm going to spend a key point and flurry.
All right.
Yeah!
Nice! Roll me damage. 5 damage.
That looks like 7 to me.
It's 7. Shut up, you. I can math. It's. I don't play games with numbers for a living or anything. I don't know what you're talking about. Arithmetic, man. Arithmetic. So you can spend your bonus action as well?
Yeah, that was
the flurry.
I mean, that was my bonus action.
Okay. So that means Hawthorne,
You think you're a hot mephit? The fist is trained with hot coals! Hotter coals than you could ever imagine! You could call them incredibly hot coals! I don't know.
with that kind of introduction, Hawthorne has to go and see what the fuck is going on.
Alright.
Yeah, you can just hear yelling.
Like, the fuck? So I guess I'm gonna try and go up the thing as well. I can't see anything to shoot at, so yeah, I'm gonna go up.
All right. Fucking the fist, man. All right, roll me your athletics check. That's me at 17. You're good.
Am I treating this as difficult?
I'm not gonna worry about it.
All right. Okay. So I'm specifically gonna go up here. Now I can see little thing there.
Yep. Tiny little magma impy thing.
Right. So I'm just gonna go at it with both barrels.
You're gonna go both barrels at the bottom one?
The top one.
All right.
That little fucker there.
Main hand, offhand?
No. Not main hand, offhand. Main hand. Because they're exactly the same, right?
Oh, yeah, because, yeah, because you have the dual-wielding fighting style. Yep. Damn. That'll be 2 hits. So give me the 2 sets of damage.
The pistol's damage.
And also give me your blood rate damage as well. Now this is,
oh, wow.
This is cold damage. Wow.
For fuck's sake.
You are nailed fucking it. On point. Now, do magma mephits, do they have, they don't have, oh, they do have vulnerability cold, so that will be 2 damage from each one.
Wow.
That's impressive. That's going to be a total of 12, yep. 12 and 4 for minus 16. You just did enough to kill it. So that's going to be, a problem for the fist. You see, when a magma mephit dies, it explodes in a burst of lava. Each creature within 5 feet of it must make a DC 11 dexterity save or take 2d6 fire damage on a failed save, half as much on a successful one.
The fist is not worried.
The fist is taking 7 damage.
The fist leans into it as it explodes and takes it on the chin, like.
Just like bring it. So this very like Victorian noble looking guy with a scowl on his face just comes up with dual pistols and just blam blam. The pistols are like dripping in his blood, and every time he fires the muzzle blast from like the muzzle flash isn't fire. It's a burst of like icy frost into the air. Right, and as the little iron balls pierce the Mephit's body, they freeze it into being like this very what's it called? You get the magma, and then it solidifies. It's the black. What is that rock?
Obsidian.
I don't think
charcoal.
Obsidian is no. Like Minecraft has ruined me because I just want to call it obsidian, but it does not. Fuck it. So it's all black and crusty and bad, and the Mephit dies in an explosion of dead. Okay. Fuck it.
An explosion of dead.
That is how I was so into that description for that death until I couldn't find the right fucking word. Now, fuck it. All right. So, is that everybody who's gone to the PC's turn and the Grizzly's turn? The Grizzly.
Yep.
Is it my
the
turn?
Grizzly.
Yep. It's my turn. Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Your turn.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, catch a tiger by the destiny token, because I don't know who I'm attacking. I'm going to settle this with dice. Now, Destiny Tokens! This is a good chance to explain Destiny Tokens. If you are new here, whenever there is something that's going to be settled strictly with dice, not stats and not choices, but strictly dice, what I do is I put it up to a Destiny Token. Now, Destiny Tokens are one of the things you can get by donating to the channel along with Unnatural Dice, so on and so forth. The rules for this shit is all in the underneath the stream and or YouTube video. I think we put it in the description for Unnatural Dice. The idea is, we let the audience choose what the die roll is going to be. So, evens equals Lola, odds equals Grizzly. Does anybody want to spend a Destiny token, or am I going to roll that out? We call this playing tag when the GM doesn't know who he's going to beat the fuck out of. And, nobody's jumping on the chance to kill Grizzly, really? I'm gonna be so happy if I kill Grizzly today. All right, so.
Wow. So mean.
Oh, you'll understand why. You'll understand why. I said odds was Grizzly, right?
Yes. Well, even.
Yeah.
Grizzly. One's even.
Shh. Grizzly, come here, boy. Actually, if I come around like this, I won't provoke, but I will get fire breath. Both. Well, actually, no. Lola, you're out of the way. So the Mephit would want to do it up like here. So this is Hawthorne and Grizzly.
Sure.
Both of you, DC 11 deck saves. The damage I'm rolling for this is pow. 10 damage. It's a pass. Oh, you fail, Grizzly. You fail.
I'm not raging yet, so that actually hurts.
All right. So you'll both take 10, except for Hawthorne. You're gonna take 5. So really, that's not both of you taking 10 at all. And then...
I'm glad we clarified that, thank you.
Lola, this guy passed his stealth check so that you don't know he's there. That means he has advantage on this attack.
Oh shit.
I didn't even see that little shit.
I know. That'll hit, I assume. For a grand total of... Fuck your mother damage! Take 5 slashing damage, Lola.
Ow, my shin.
A little Mephit will, like, scamper across the floor. It'll start, like, gnawing on your leg.
Ow! What? Foul little fire creature!
All right. That'll pass it to Grizzly.
How's my hair looking?
Your hair does not look like it's been singed yet.
Oh, I'm gonna quickly look down and in a panic. I'm gonna look up. I'm gonna notice this shit's using fire. I'm gonna get so angry that it's trying to burn my new coat.
And by coat, we mean chest hair on your ass.
My this bear coat.
My bear coat.
And I'm gonna rage, obviously, and then come down at it with my great axe.
Alright. Roll me the attack! Wham!
So close.
Giveth me damage. 13.
15 cause rage.
15 cause rage. Alright, he is still standing. So as is the way of these things, you fought these little buggers before, actually. They tend to arrive whenever there is fire that is tainted by malignant magic. Malignant, is that a word?
It was.
It's a fucking word now, isn't it?
Malignant's a word?
It is a word, yeah.
It probably does not mean at all what I used it for. But that's okay, because the way that you kill these motherfuckers is by turning your weapon on the flat side and squishing them like a pancake! And you're gonna almost do enough, so you're gonna come down, clang, and this little method is gonna be like, yep, that's gonna hurt, feel that one in the morning. It's like, you know, like, his head is crooked to the side, and like, his leg is sticking out. Grizzly, okay, Grizzly's down. Fist, Hawthorne, Lola, who has an action they know they want to take?
I'm gonna turn around and, blast this little shit that bit me on the leg with a Frostbolt? Is that what it's called?
Frostbolt.
I have something frosty. Ray of Chill Frost. Touch. That's what
Ray
it's called.
All right. Okay. This is a ranged attack. However, you are in melee with this little bugger, and so you're going to have disadvantage on this attack.
Okay. I'm pissed at it. I don't really care.
Yep. Let her rip.
Oh, shit.
Watch. All right. So. Thankfully, there is no way I can rule that you guys, like, I only rule, like, oh, you hit somebody you weren't intending to in a botch, like, if it's legit. Like, you're not gonna be like, I'm gonna shoot you, oh no, Grizzly! Right, like, as much as I want to do that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna say, that, okay, so you're, this thing is, like, trying to, it's on your, like, right? And so you go to cast your spell at it. And what's going to happen is I'm going to let this spell hit this motherfucker. So go ahead and roll me damage. Did I use malignant to mean exactly what I meant? Man, I'm good at this. Thank you, Mr. Word.
Yeah, malignant is...
is evil. Evil, okay.
Basically.
All right, so you're going
to... It can also mean, like, infectious, but yeah.
All right, so what we're going to do here, okay, is we're going to say that you do the full 14 damage to this kid, right? But in the process of you being like with your ice spell, like it's like and it starts like scrambling and clawing up your leg to the ammo pouch that you have. This thing is made of fire. So the ammo pouch is gonna blow, and it's gonna do. I'm gonna use its fire breath. So make me a DC 11 dexterity save. Take 6 fire damage, as like the gunpowder, right, blows and reduce your ammo count by 1. It should have started at 2. It is barely still hanging on. Like, it's like grabbing, it's like biting your hip, right? Like clawing and dripping like magma and fire down your leg, burning you. So that's Lola. Hawthorne?
I do apologize for that explosion. It wasn't my intention, but I have other things to deal with. Don't worry about it, though. I wouldn't panic. We're far enough away from the others.
I'm going to turn around. I'm going to shoot the others. But I can only see one of them, right?
You can see from up top. You can see down very easily.
Oh.
You just can't see the other way.
Does Lola still have movement?
Lola can move, yes. She would risk provoking an attack of opportunity if she moved out of his threat range, though. The question is it better to provoke and risk a swing or get caught in the blast? And the answer is it's better to provoke and miss a swing.
Just letting you know, love, I'm about to open up both barrels on that little fuck. This
one
up here exploded.
Clawing at my leg right now?
I'm sure you could juggle it off.
It mechanically, it's not grappled to you, so the narrative will have you leaving
right,
behind.
Okay, I'm gonna attempt to get the hell out of the way.
All right.
By the way, if you were talking to the fist when you said the like, I'm sorry, it blew up in your face thing.
Yeah, yeah.
There's like this connection, like eye contact, where she just goes, "I just finished killing that thing's boss. The fist isn't scared of a little warm bath."
I'll keep that in mind. Thank you.
Take inspiration for constructing a ridiculous tall tale that didn't actually happen. And thus playing out your madness. So the fist is down for the madness for the session. Hawthorne, if you want, you can take inspiration for your, like, no need to panic, very calm and orderly, informing people of what you're going to do, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, I was either going to play that like that, or I was like, I'm really sorry, mother would hate me, kind of, but yeah.
All right. So, Lola, you can move away, and I'll allow you to climb up into a safe square.
Yay,
here.
Finally.
Just because I'm not looking for this fight to be super challenging.
Right, so I'm shooting my first shot at, if I had to reduce my ammo count, or is that only because...
Okay, the only time ammo count reduces is when, your ammo count reduces when you, botch, or when I tell you it does.
You still have to reload,
because your gun's capacity reduces, like, the individual bullets in the gun, like, how many bullets you can load at a time, you still have to reload on every third shot out of the gun. So you can shoot twice,
so
and then you have
one...
to spend an action to reload, yeah.
So I've had one from each, I get to shoot again, and then I have to reload, right?
Correct. Now, right, only takes one action to reload both the pistols. That's the pistol's special property, because it's supposed to be dual-wielded. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to shoot the little Mephit down at the ramp first. And I will use my inspiration, because...
All right.
Fuck it.
This is the first shot. That'll hit.
Yep.
It's looking pretty wounded. So roll me damage on this one first. And roll me your... Oh god, this thing is so toast. And it will explode harmlessly. And then you can spend your second shot on the Magma Mephit that is also almost dead because Grizzly.
Did I take any damage from that one that was on my leg when I moved?
No, it was a swing and a miss.
Alright then, I like that.
Too bad you didn't
Yeah, I know.
Spend inspiration on this one. Let me see it. That'll be 7 and 1. That's 7 and 2 is 9. It had 7 HP. So, Grizzly, roll me DC 11 deck save as it explodes.
That's what you get for not going with the party, bitch.
Nope.
Take 9 fire damage.
4 because bear.
Oh, yeah, because rage.
Yeah.
Okay, ow. That will end all of the fire methods. They were each CR... They were each 100 XP. There were 3 of them. It says 300 XP divided by 4 players is going to be... each of you will earn 75 experience for having defeated the Magma Methods.
Nice.
Now!
I'm going to reload, first of all.
Yep.
I'm checking my hair after the explosion.
They've scorched and singed a bunch of it, but it's
oh
fine.
Oh my god.
I walk over to the group.
Yeah.
And say, new people! Coming through the doors! Always nice. Welcome to the party!
Who are you?
Some people call me the Raging Fury. Other people call me the storm of the north wind. Others have been known to call me that dwarf drunk in the corner. My name is the Fist, and I am the best ever.
Did you say you were the best?
The tales of my exploits span far and wide. The foes I've defeated, the monsters I've killed, the women and men who have fallen for me. Everyone loves the Fist.
Right, well, unfortunately...
Did I just hear the words? Everyone loves the
Everyone
Fist?
Everyone loves the Fist. I think we need to add quote that.
That was the filthiest thing I think has been said on this channel.
I just want to add as well, and you can't teach that!
That is a definite beat. That is a beat being called by the audience. I can't fucking handle you, Distract. This is. On that note, it is top of the hour, 13 minutes past, so we're gonna take a 3 to 5 minute break. Welcome back to twitch.evilsqueegee! I am Evil Squeegee, this is D&D. That rhymed because I do this all the time and I don't know the rhythm to this song, so I am making up the words as I go along, and here's the fist!
Hi.
What just happened?
Can I just say that I want to add some stuff as, like, if this were a TV show and we just, like, faded out to commercials and then we came back, the fist is talking to Grizzly and going, there are also a couple of other names, and it sort of fades on with just, like, her saying names of stuff that she's called, like, the Claw of the Bouncing Lion, the breath of fresh air before the last fall, the feeling you get when you're about to get punched.
Right.
Like, so many names, just...
I mean, all your fancy doodads and names are cool and all, but you know why you've never heard of me? Because anyone who's heard of me is dead.
How many times have you been to the bottom of this manor and back out? This is my fifth time.
Right.
I live in here.
Right, well...
I kill things for fun that get in my way and go squish very nicely between my fingertips.
Hawthorne is like...
Mama Bear saved me.
Lola's just kind of sitting around sniffing or seeing if she could, you know, smell anything important because she's not listening to that. Her ears are far too sensitive to listen to arguing.
Everything here is choked and smoky, and you can smell nothing except for the faint scent of... Is that inspiration you smell? Ah, yes, for playing your madness. Yes, that smells like inspiration and smoke.
Right. Fist, right?
One of my many names, but the most common, yes.
Alright, I get the gist of it, Fist. If you are the best, I propose a competition.
Very well, the Fist accepts. What's the competition?
Well, I haven't thought that far ahead, see. Normally people are scared to...
I don't suggest you pick an eating competition. The Fist can eat 7 pies in 3 seconds, along with a side serving of several pounds of ice cream.
Did I already give you inspiration for your madness, Elf?
Yeah, you did.
Okay. Did you spend it?
No.
Okay, so you should. Okay, so I'm gonna put a green dot in.
I can go forever, so just, like, move the scene along whenever feel like it's necessary.
I'm looking around the room. What could, like, what looks like it should be heavy or unbreakable or something like that around this room right now?
I mean, there's a wall.
There's walls, bookcases, there's rubble, there's you.
Alright, well... You see that wall right there?
I have a suggestion.
I do.
So, if this is Hawthorne, go ahead, give me a suggestion.
I'll call back. If you two want to see who's got the strongest punch, you should try punching each other's fists and see what happens.
I agree. That is a good idea.
Done!
All right.
So I would like both
break some bones.
Okay, so Grizzly and the Fist. All right. I would like to ask both of you. You get one action that you can spend to prepare yourself for this. And what is it going to be?
I would like to take an action to introduce my fists. Shock and awe.
All right. Grizzly?
You will have the honor, my friend, of being punched on your knuckles by Shock. Because Aw is tired of listening to your mouth.
I have a very important question.
What's up, Mystic?
Do I have corn in my rations? Because I would like to set it on fire so that Hawthorne and I could eat it.
All right.
Oh, hang on. Oh, shit. Dreadnought says, "Evil Squeegee, give a crit to Elf using one of my tokens."
Oh no! I'm going to say because this is a competition. I want this to be all natural. Unfortunately, I really feel like this not being all natural would be contrary to the spirit of the moment.
All right. So I'm so angry that she keeps thinking she's all big and mighty. She's the best at this and that. I'm gonna fucking rage.
All right. Now I want both of you to make an attack roll. Do you have the frenzied attacks thing that gives you advantage, but everybody else advantage to hit you?
Reckless attack. Oh yeah.
Okay, yeah. Do you want to use it? Everything above level 2 has that as a barbarian.
Oh yeah. I
all right.
Definitely.
So I want both of you to roll me an attack with advantage.
Okay.
I don't actually have. An attack for unarmed.
There you go.
Oh no! That's a nat 20. All right, Jonables, can you do it? Just make me a great sword attack. It's fine.
Okay.
Can you nat 20? Can you nat 20? Can you? No.
No.
Oh! All right. So roll me damage. All right. So take 5.
I'm a bear.
Alright. So take 2.5. take 2.
No, that was a crit, right? So that does all of it.
The secondary the plus X is
in there. Okay. Yeah, yep.
Those pluses should not be there. I don't know why the macro is putting them there.
The legend of the fist continues.
Alright, so Grizzly, right? Grizzly, you're like, alright. You know what? No. I'm gonna channel the spirits. The totems of my family and you, right? And there will be a shockwave, or at least you think there was a shockwave. And both of you will be like, boom, and stumble back, except for the fist, who stands icy cold still.
Yeah. I would like to say that the punch from my fist shock is just...
It's a one-inch punch?
Right, and muscles rippling and knuckles singing through the air, and when it's said and done, you are stumbled back just barely.
I'm going to give Grizzly my best eyebrow raise.
Roll me charisma. How good is your best eyebrow raise?
Oh, it's pretty fucking
pretty
good.
You have a pretty fucking incredible eyebrow raise going on there. It would appear, Grizzly, the fist is aptly named. There is no shame in having pulled back after that punch, because you didn't pull back. Her sheer strength, her knuckliness, forced your hand back.
Have no fear, my friend! The fist is on your side! I will protect you.
Right, well, whatever. This fucking leg obviously maybe wimp out a little bit. Fucking hell.
Wow.
That was a wonderful idea, Hawthorne.
And I was gonna say, I tried to remove the net, I was like, no, Dreadnought, you can't spend a destiny token to make that, because that's gonna be all natural. I'm not gonna force that to be a crit. She fucking crits it anyways. Even without the advantage.
It's a punching competition for the fist. Like, if I didn't I'd be really surprised.
Don't you fucking love it, like, when the dice are just like, and this is the only way this should happen. Right, like,
and now that GIF got played out for the tweet, so hiya. can I get inspiration for trying to be the best?
Yes, you can. Megalomania, inspiration, go.
I mean, it looks like the chat's beating for you as well for the hobbling off screen.
Yeah.
Yep, and take a beat. Take a beat. That is good stuff. That is good stuff. I liked it. You guys, the audience today is really active. Like, you guys got beats flying left and right. This is This is good shit. Bravo. Beat for you guys. You guys get a beat. We don't normally have that many people calling beats, like, because people are fucking lazy, I guess. Shrug.
Yep.
How many tweets are we up? 7 to go before that giveaway happens, guys. 7 retweets of today's going live tweet. The chat will have the link for you. All right, so...
So, Lola's like, you know, that was a good idea. It was really for late, so...
Oh, thank you. I'm not normally known for my brains, but I think it was pretty apt in this situation. However, seeing that you seem to have taken some damage... Here, have a little swig on this. After all, what would Mother think if I left a lady in that sort of state?
Why, thank you. The spirits appreciate your kindness.
I'll give him a lesser restoration potion.
Lesser restoration? Is the fist not also a lady? Is the fist not also lava splash?
Oh, wait, the restoration, hang on, the restoration's a curse one, isn't it?
It's full of, like, diseases and poison.
Conditions,
and like
She can have it anyway. It's fine.
So do I have to roll something, or do I?
I got confused. Like the less restoration.
There's no point to drinking it right now. You're better off saving it and using it later.
Okay, then I will do that.
Yeah.
All right. I don't usually do this, but you know, fucking bestie over there, or whatever. I'm a bit shaken up at the moment. I get my whip out, and I go, "I'm gonna shoot," and use rope trick.
All right, it's Rakashinu. You have the tale of Rakashinu.
Yeah.
Rakashinu is the goblin god of the Everdeep setting. Rakashinu is a trickster. Rakashinu is a deceiver. Rakashinu is rich as fuck. And this whip that you pull out, Rakashinu's tail, it's a +1 whip. But it is made to look like this giant rat's tail with like a bone handle. And when you crack the whip and you say the command word, the name of the goblin god, it straightens up. And at the top, like an interdimensional hole just kind of like opens up. It's pitch black and you can climb up there and it is a safe place to rest if you guys want to call a short rest, provided he feels like, you can short rest down here as well, but it's, you know, nice and air conditioned in his, interdimensional pocket there.
Sure. I'll climb the thing into the portal. I'm not afraid.
All right, so it is a short rest. You guys can spend hit dice if you want.
I do.
I would like to.
All right, go ahead and spend. There's no point in not spending all of your hit dice. Just things over. What?
I rolled a one.
How many
on the D12.
Ones are getting rolled today? This is what you get for critting your punching competition there, Fist. What is happening?!
Oh, I love it that it's not me! I'm just saying this now. Like, the fact that it's not me rolling shitty today. Yeah.
Is that 4 actually just giving me 4 hit points? Or
4
is that
HP.
Less?
Okay.
4 hit points,
Each thing is. Yeah. And you can spend up to 3.
Oh, there you go.
Dice. There you go.
I mean, that last one, I need 1, but I was like, screw it, I'll use it for 1 HP. Oh yeah! Now I rolled a high one.
All right, I'm not gonna spend my last one because I'm up to 23.
Okay.
Which is
we have 3 retweets to go. By the way, guys.
3 retweets to go, guys. 3.
For a massive super secret that none of us, apart from him,
it's a fisting.
Yeah,
that's what you just had.
You get a knight with the fist in Everdeep. Only 3 to go before the giveaway, guys. Alright, so everybody's all of your stuff that resets on short rest will reset. Everybody can have the chance to reload all of their guns. Does anybody want to spend
Do I still get my inspiration from my what would Mother think if I did this?
Have I already given you madness? No, I don't think I have.
No,
so
you
go
haven't.
Ahead and take your inspiration.
I reload my fists.
Unfortunately, I don't get my rages back, so I'm down to 1.
Ooh, because you used one.
Good going, Grizzly.
Yo.
All right.
I hope that fight was worth it.
So, the only direction you can progress is a curiosity to everyone at the very least. Because these two front doors, these two massive, huge, hulking doors have been thoroughly shackled and locked. unpassable barriers the entire time any of you have been venturing into the manor. But tonight, on this fiery, agonizing burning night, where all of you seem to have been drawn here independently, by that which you desire most, compelled in a fearful sort of way, or an angry sort of way, you've all found yourselves delivered unto this open door. Assembled. And beyond that door lies a thick, inky blackness. Shadow. Lightlessness. Darkness.
Using my amazing powers of prediction, the fist is going to posit that through there is something to punch. And then I am going to step through.
I don't suppose you... Oh, you've already gone. All right, then.
All right. You step through.
I can punch hard. There's stuff to punch.
Grizzly does not like me.
Okay, so the fist. You step through the door, and it's dark.
Guns out, by the way.
Yep.
Great axe out, obviously.
I shout back through the darkness. It is dark in here!
Would you like to light a torch?
I thought perhaps it was some kind of barrier. But the fist now sees nothing, because it is dark.
Have you,
Also, don't I have dark vision? I'm a dwarf!
Dark vision is one of the things I've removed for the Everdeep world.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because it's just a pain in the dick to, like, DM it properly and still get creepy haunted house bullshit.
I lived in darkness, but I cannot see this darkness. Fire would be the answer.
I would get a torch out, but I currently have my guns out.
I'll get a torch out.
All right, Lola. I will give you 30-foot light radius for a torch. That is what we've ruled him to be. Wow, my fucking roll 20.
The fist also removes a torch and lights it, because the fist can punch with other fists for a while.
All right, just one second here. The fist was already in, so let me get the token set up before anybody goes crawling through, because this is where all the bullshit goes down. All right, the fist... and Lola, and we're just going to pile everybody in. I assume you guys are following.
Yeah. Begrudgingly.
Yeah, I'll go in afterwards.
All right,
so I'm holding the torch, but I kind of want, like, one of the two punchy punch guys to go ahead of me, because I'm a weakling.
All right, we'll put Lola in the back behind Grizzly, because Grizzly's the bar, and you guys will have a half-decent marching order. Step through...
all the attacks come from behind. RIP.
You guys get attacked by fireballs behind! No, so as you step in, what you are witnessing is the most grandiose, grand, massive, expansive ceiling, as high as you can imagine. The floor here is expertly crafted, fallen into decay, with a very fine red velvet carpet with a royal pattern. This is the throne room of the giant king.
The fist could jump that high if she wanted.
All right, so I'll get there. People go, why is he freaking out? I'll explain in a moment. All right. There are paintings, massive paintings that reach as high as the ceiling, and the fog and mist is thick. And up ahead, you see two growling hellhounds just kind of lying there, eyeing you for a moment. And you see the ghost of the mad scientist, the half-giantess, Ava, half-elf, half-giant, just covered in technology and needles on her fingers and steampunk prosthetics and every bit here. Just on a huge long white coat that's tattered. You can't see her feet as she's floating on a very tall, very massive 60-foot staircase that leads up to a giant throne. And on that throne, which is glowing, pulsing with a black magic. There is a ring of dark blue fire, leaving scars on the surface of the throne. And standing in the center of that throne is a dwarf with guns in either hands. And he now has half of a steampunk face, and one of his hands is steampunk, and he's got tubes and pipes pumping infernal chemicals through his corpse. He's been rotting for quite a while. And Ava is, don't worry, I've called them. You will get my vengeance. Yes, you will. They killed my mother. No, I will kill them all. They will come to me and you shall be my weapon. And then she'll turn. Now, as everybody sees Ava for the first time, she turns. You! And she points at you, not necessarily recognizing anybody in specific, just having a hatred for the living, for those who dare cost her mother's life. And everybody who lays eyes on the twisted monstrosity that is Ava's face, that is Ava's very existence, her true madness takes physical form in her ghost body. And everybody here is going to make a charisma save versus madness. Grizzly, you get advantage on this because you had some rest and relaxation.
I puke again.
Oh, shit!
Well, I fucking fell anyway!
fuck it.
So while they're rolling these saves, the reason why everybody is like, what? McCloud was the ranger that Jonables played in his very first ever deep event.
I hate you.
And McCloud died because the party just noped the fuck out.
First session of Everdeep ever. Yeah. I was the first death in Everdeep.
He was the first character death. And now he has been rebuilt. Okay, so who passed a DC 12?
I did.
That would be Elf.
Really?
That's it.
Okay, yep. Guys.
The fist is unfazed by this woman. Haven't I killed her before?
She's run away from you every time, which is exactly what she's doing now, actually. Because the last time she engaged mortals in combat, they kicked her ass.
So if this is going to be... I've already got madness too, so I get permanent now, right?
If your madness...
Did you not cleanse it?
If you failed... If you failed, your madness level will increase by one. Grizzly, you did cash in the Templar favor. No, it was Hawthorne who cashed in the Templar favor. All right, so yeah. Everybody who failed, increase your madness level by one.
Mine's at three.
Mine's right. At one.
I'm at two.
So, what's going to happen here is everybody who failed is going to have a madness. Now, everybody who failed their check versus madness, this is another chart to roll on. So, what we're going to do is, down the list, everybody's going to get the chance to spend a destiny token to pick the madnesses that inflict everybody. Who has one?
I have one.
Lola, you should have two.
I have two. Lola has two. I didn't cleanse it from last time.
Yep.
Right?
We've got one, two, and three going
down
the list.
Alright, so let's go down the list. Hawthorne. Alright. Does anybody want to pick Hawthorne's madness? Or are we all waiting for Grizzlies? Because the audience is going to get to choose. Now, Grizzly has a third level madness.
Money shot.
Crits for McCloud from Pyromancy. Oh, God, you have no idea.
I'm just going to give them to you as the GM.
Yep, that is correct.
Where was that when I was playing McCloud?
I know.
By the way, I think I still have a crit from Dreadnire. I don't know.
Yes, you do have a crit from Dreadnire lined up. Yep. I just wasn't allowing it to affect the competition roll, that's all. Okay, so nobody closed, nobody spent a destiny token, so roll me.
We also hit 30. Hit the target, by the way.
30 for the giveaway. Don't worry, I noticed. I am going to need reminders, but I did notice. So I am going to ask you, Hawthorne, to roll me a D10 and a D100. On a 63, you have disadvantage on ability checks.
And vivid hallucinations.
Yes. So that's disadvantage on ability checks for 20
for
minutes.
For 2 minutes.
Which is the whole fight, basically.
20, yeah, fuck.
Alright, oh no, sorry, 2 minutes. It is the whole fight, though. It's, 12 rounds. Alright, so, next up is gonna be, Long-Term Madness for Lola. Kylania would like to spend
a
Destiny
God,
token.
Oh my god, don't go so fast.
Alright, so, Kylania, what role would you like the dice to make, Kylania? The audience member here is choosing the number of the dice roll. I am the one who winds up interpreting things to be situation appropriate. This is, however, the second time that you've gained madness after witnessing Ava, so I'll try and make it Ava-centric if I can manage. Constant Brilliant. Babbling. Oh, God. Oh, God.
That's a short-term one, right? That's not the long term.
41 to 50 is going to be...
Babbling? So you're looking. You need to look at the long-term one, dude. Constant babbling. The second one I linked is the long-term madness. They have different tables. So I will be linking another one for
yep.
Journables.
Grizzly is
going to
have
be...
another new chart as well.
Yep. Wow.
And go ahead and roll me a d10, Mystic, to see how long whatever they pick will last. Wow, 80 hours. 46 to 55 is going to be the character becomes attached to a lucky charm, such as a person or an object, that is and has disadvantage attack checks, ability checks, saving throws well more than 30 feet from it. I am going to say... your lucky charm is steampunk technology. Elven tech.
Oh, now, that's mean! Lucky, okay.
I know, right? Lucky you, Grizzly happens to have a +1 elven tech mace. So you do not have...
I don't have to touch it, right? I just have to...
You just have to be within 30 feet of it. And if you leave 30 feet, you're gonna get... you get a disadvantage. The reason I didn't link it to the fist is because this might actually come back to haunt Lola in a future adventure.
It's true.
And I don't want to. I don't want to give Lola permanent permanent disadvantage. Okay. Whenever Elf isn't playing.
Okay, so the I just need to be near Grizzly's mace, right?
Yes,
within 30.
Oh yeah, you do.
Wow,
I got some elven technology in my loincloth for you, lady.
It's actually on the harness now.
It is, I'm honest now.
Suddenly
all right.
I feel drawn to this technological device that is so evil. It's... Oh, the spirits are not going to like this, but it's so pretty.
It's true. It's true.
It's worth pointing out that when we get people to pick stuff, you pick the thing from the list. Squeechy will interpret how that is manifest.
Yep.
Like, I don't know how my manifestation is going to be with, like, the madness stuff.
The hallucinations, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Alright, so, also, McCloud, 30 feet of McCloud will also count. However, McCloud is 60 feet up. Alright. And then, the moment you've all been waiting for...
Wait, one more question. What about Dr. Ava? Because she's covered in steampunk technology. She left?
She left.
She's gone.
But if she comes back, I can...
Yes.
Okay.
The moment you've all been waiting for. Ladies and
gentlemen. There's the table, by the way.
Sarah beats him to it! Ah! I see Sarah.
Bond went. He bought D tokens.
Yeah.
So he could win.
Yeah, he bought those D tokens and everybody was sitting like, I'ma get you, Jonable. Alright, this is what you get for being a regular.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see what your permanent madness will be. Alright, Sarah wins it. So, what roll do you want? This is an additional madness. Permanent madnesses, you can actually, like, you can only trigger a madness, but this is a secondary madness for your character. It can give you inspiration. It is permanent.
I love it. Everyone's so fucking keen to wreck people.
And Sam is now salty because he thought Sarah was saving all of her Destiny tokens to fuck over his character.
Yep.
I'm just waiting to see what happens to Grizzly before we move on here. 26 to 30 is going to be, I try to become more like someone else I know, adopting his or her style of dress, mannerisms.
Oh, there is only one way this could go.
Grizzly.
Who have you just been bested by?
The only way. The only way. The only way. You
okay.
You must now do your best. You can get your madness by trying to dress like the Fist, trying to talk like the Fist, trying to act like the Fist.
A poor impersonation of the otherwise scintillating jewel that is the Fist.
You know what, Alex? You should probably give that elven tech mace to someone else. You don't need it anymore, right?
Give it to me! I'll hold it!
Okay, so. So, you step through. Ava twists your mind. Alright? Hawthorne. You are actually convinced that this entire place is riddled with ghosts trying to claw their way up out of the floors, out of the walls, but they're fought back and restrained by something. The barrier between the realms, maybe? This is distracting, dangerous, unsettling. You will have disadvantage on all mundane ability checks. This does not include saving throws. This does not include attack checks. Pyromancy has donated $20, says, I just noticed I'm down to one token. Give me more. I need them for Snidely. That's actually two Destiny tokens, bro. Destiny tokens are $10 a pop. So, that's Hawthorne, all right? You're starting to see ghosts. Grizzly. Grizzly. Mother Bear can only take the best. And, you know what? No, fuck this. You can be better. You can be better than the Fist. The Fist has just shown you the way to being, proving that you are better. You just need to be more like the Fist, and you will find the next rung. You will become the Fist, so Fist will not be better than you. Fist will at best be as good as you are. Right.
If I survive, I'm totally taking the level of Monk next.
Do it!
Yes!
Lola, what did you roll?
I have to be your steampunk technology.
Obviously, the ghost is using it to raise the dead. The ghost is using it to defend herself. And you watched her die. You defeated that ghost. You yourself were present. You might not have landed the killing blow, but damn if you didn't help.
I almost died myself.
Yeah, she almost killed you, and you watched her die. And now here she is, and all this tech... Man, this tech stuff's gotta be pretty good.
You were now... Even if it is terribly, terribly wrong.
Alright, now... This will be an initiative check.
Wait, I have a question.
The Grizzly! So I'll go first.
Okay. Is Grizzly still holding his mace?
It's in my harness.
Yeah, he has it
so
on.
I just need to be nearby him. Okay.
Yeah, you need to be within a Swix scare spread.
Swix. Okay.
Six.
Don't worry, I can only move 15 feet.
Where are you? Where are you, McLeod, spawn of Ava? Here is your.
Do you want me to roll for the party, even though I would technically get disadvantage on this?
Don't take disadvantage.
Because I have the highest initiative.
Don't take disadvantage on it because you are rolling for the party.
Oh.
What the fuck?
Who wins, party or McLeod initiative tie? Just in case somebody wants to decide that you guys are truly fucked. If somebody spends a Destiny token, otherwise I'll let the party take the tie. All right,
we're good.
Okay, so it'll be Grizzly, then the party.
Oh, Sam, fuck's sake! Sam did send us after.
You know what? Because I fucked him on his unnatural die token.
Yep.
I'll give this one to him. It's gonna be Grizzly, then the boss, monsters, and then the party. All right, Grizzly.
He hasn't specified, has he?
Although
I'm pretty sure he's gonna fuck us over.
Oh, I'm going first. I am now, obviously, going to charge headlong into danger without worry of any consequence and dash in full prone after my thing.
Okay, I did say this was probably gonna kill people, but alright, so you're gonna dash. That means you can go a full 30 feet.
Full prone is a tactical position for versus a guy with guns.
That is true. All right, and you're gonna fall prone. All right.
Here you go.
Do you have any action? Do you have any bonus actions you'd like to spend?
Ow. That's it.
All right. You're not going to rage?
Not yet.
Am I still within range?
I have one use. I have to be careful.
All right. So, Grizzly? Grizzly?
Hello.
Johnables?
Yes.
It brings me great pleasure to attempt to kill you with you. McLeod makes two attacks per round. One with Hex, his gun. One with Hax, his other gun. Each of these guns have these steampunk devices like built into them and around them. Each one has a special mechanic attached to them. Alright. Let's see, does he have... Okay. Alright! So he's gonna shoot Hex, targeting Grizzly.
Oh shit.
Oh! Oh wait, no, this is a nat crit. This is an unnatural crit. Right? Yeah, yeah. So it would have crit anyways. So you're gonna take, he doesn't do piercing damage, he does poison damage, by the way. So you're gonna take 6 plus 7 is, I can do math in the morning, 13 poison damage. I'm also gonna need a DC 12 con saving throw.
Nope.
All right, you are poisoned for 1 minute. That's disadvantage on everything.
I actually
think it's in the player's handbook at the back. Is it just ability checks, or does it apply to attack rolls as well?
Just ability checks.
All right, so...
No, wait. Is it attack rolls?
Attack rolls and ability checks.
Yeah, wow.
So the bullets start ripping through you, right? And they start doing... They start, like, you know, they're laced with something. Something hellish, something deadly. All right? And then I'm going to shoot Hax. I don't think I have another crit lined up for... Is this an all-natural check?
You used your first crit, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, it's all natural.
Wow, shit.
Take 7 poison and make me a DC 12 con save.
Nope.
Alright, at the start of each round... You will lose 1d10 HP, as acid is now melting your body.
Oh my
god! At the start of
my
next turn, if he rolls a 10, I'm unconscious.
Now, I also...
Ow.
I'm not
is that something... Sorry.
I'm not gonna sick the Hellhounds on Grizzly. McLeod, with a smirk, makes me go double-check what his madness was. Oh yeah, no, he swears a vow, doesn't he? That was his thing.
Yep.
And so... McLeod, right? He opens his mouth as Grizzly is running towards the staircase, and he grunts a wet, bloody, like the blood is like dripping down his mouth and out the corner of his eye, right? And he says, "You slain my mother's mother, and I swear I will kill you all." And both of the guns come up, and there is a charge of energy as he boom, 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 boom unleashes a cacophony of gunshots as little bolts of green glowing liquid coating the bullets come slamming, turning Grizzly into a pile of Swiss cheese. Doesn't look good for Grizzly. And then he grunts, he says, "Sick 'em, boys." And then 1, 2, these are medium creatures, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't think I get close enough. Do the Hellhounds have movement speed of 40? They can.
Did
I
you
have
just
40?
Go into Grizzly's range and then run out of it again?
No. It's because the token is large sized, but the creatures are medium.
Money shot.
Right. Okay.
That's a crit to the GM. Snidely will be the lone survivor of the world from drill. Okay. So I am not in range for anybody there, but I can also close to this. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Fist, come here. Actually, wait, what am I doing? I can fucking fire breath. 15-foot cone, this is everybody. Each creature makes a DC 12 dex saving throw, please.
I'd like to take my inspiration.
You may.
You crit because of thing anyway.
You crit, you don't need to use your inspiration, yeah. You've got a crit.
Oh.
All right, as a bonus for that crit, because unnatural dice are they are the icing on the cake, I will let you take a 5-foot step out of the way of the cone and take a punch for free.
Wait.
So roll me that attack there. Can I get a save from Lola? Did you pass?
I got a 13.
I'm going to use my inspiration as well.
You better damn well do that.
Good job I did. Holy fuck.
Take half of this. It's fire damage, if that's relevant to anybody.
10 so wait, damage.
Did I pass it or not?
You passed, yes. It's a DC 12. Everybody passed, and the fist crit. So everybody's going to take 10 damage, except for the fist, who gets away scot-free and makes a punch.
I've used up all of my temporary health now.
Okay. The fist. Did you get your attack yet?
Asshole.
Yeah, it's right there.
You fell on your face.
That whiffs by one. They have AC 11.
Yeah, I thought it would.
One, two. Oh, wait, no, he can't go. Because I did everything there. All right, so there is a growling coming from this corner. There's another hellhound here. And that's going to be top of the action. Grizzly, roll me D10!
The party needs to go.
We actually haven't had our turn yet, yeah.
Oh, the party needs to go.
Can we have a turn?
Sorry, I'm so used to the monsters going last. Lola, Fist, Hawthorne, what are you doing?
Well, I'm punching the absolute crap out of this hellhound, I think.
Yep.
I'll pick it up and drop it over my knee.
Well, actually, is the one nearest to me close enough for me to thunder wave it?
Yeah, but I think you'll also hit the fist if you thunder wave.
You might hit people.
Oh. I can solve that problem.
All right.
I take a step back, still in threat range, but I wouldn't get hit by a thunder wave.
I do have a question, though.
What's up?
Are these animals?
Hellhounds are fiends. They're demons.
So, okay, never mind. So wait, is everybody away now? Can I do Thunder Wave?
Yes.
Click the Thunder Wave button so I can see the radius that it's supposed to have.
Didn't work, hang on.
Hawthorne, do you have an action? While Lola's futzing with that, go ahead.
Yeah, okay.
I'll look it up. What is your action? I'm looking it up, Lola.
My bonus action is to cast Hex.
Yep.
Which just gives you the... Because I click the thing and I don't read...
Yeah, okay, so
it puts it on...
It goes on who? Who do you want to Hex?
On the Infernal Hound closest.
Oh! It wasn't working because I have to choose what level I want to cast it at.
Okay.
Thunderwave is a 15-foot cube originating from you.
Which basically means, like, it could be the three squares in front of you, or, like, on a corner, or whatever. So.
Yeah, if she puts herself in the middle,
it doesn't have to be centered on her. She could be at the
corner. It could be this, yeah.
Okay, yeah, then you can Thunderblast the Hellhound.
Cool. Okay, I'm going to do that, and obviously before I do that, I'm going to say, I advise that you back up a little bit, and then I will.
Alright, and my Hellhound has to make a dex save, con save, and it's DC 12.
Can I shoot it first, please?
Yes.
Please? Okay. I only get, because I've already used my bonus action to put the hex on it, I won't get a second attack, but
yep.
I'm assuming 21 hits.
Yep.
With that damage...
Now, this matters. Is it your main hand or your off hand?
It doesn't matter because...
It does matter because your guns have different capacity counts.
Oh, my main hand then.
Yep. Okay, so you're going to hit with that roll for six piercing. Four crimson four. Right and D6 hex.
Three, four...
So that's 13 total damage.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. This hellhound is looking really fucked up.
Then another 6 from the
And that means the fist is the only one left to take an action.
Did you take the damage from my thunder wave?
Yes.
Okay.
It passed the save. And I'll narrate the round. The faction's turn as soon as we're done rolling it out.
I can't hear Elf.
I guess I'll punch this thing. So we can finish it off. Sorry, I don't usually push to talk, so
yeah.
Weird.
Yeah. Alright, roll me damage, that'll hit. They got AC 11.
4.
That's enough.
That's enough? Yep. I still have movement and another attack to use.
You do! provided you drop the torch.
No, I don't have to drop the torch.
Lola's got the torch.
I am a monk. I can strike with any surface of my body.
Oh, shit,
anything
really?
Anything I want, yes. Sweet. A monk could be holding a barrel in both hands, completely handless, and kick you in the face.
That's actually, I didn't know that was a mechanic. That's
it's
awesome.
A rule for monks. They could be completely no hands. I can headbutt you.
Sweet.
So I've already attacked, so I can only move 30. So I will move up to here.
Okay.
And then I will take I will use a key point and take the dodge action.
Okay, what does that do?
Gives you disadvantage to hitting me on anything.
Okay. Let's see, that is...
I get down low when I duck and weave.
All right. Okay, cool. Is that Grizzly?
Well, that would be Faction's turn now, right?
That would be the PC Faction has had their turn. Lola took her turn with a Thunder Wave. So basically what happens here is this Hellhound comes, like, darting out of the shadows, right? You can hear the growling of more than one, as you can now see here. There's another one down this way. And it kind of like jumps over the fucking pit and comes crashing down and goes to take a chomp out of Lola. Oh no, it breathes its fire, right? It'll show up and just, and as it's doing that, the fist makes a cool little like fucking duck and weave, like a side somersault roll, and comes up and uppercuts the bitch right in the jaw, and it yelps. And then between Lola finishing it up. Then, like, you know, she uppercuts at the jaw, like, the tooth flying and, the blood in the air. And then Hawthorne takes a shot with his frosty muzzle flash. Lola channels the spirits of lightning and just BOOM! In this huge, glowing thunder crack that the hound is clawing its claws into the ground. Clawing its claws. I'm really good at this. Kind of, like, scrambling to hold its position. But it's too late because the fist comes around with a fucking kick. Just BAM! And takes it out, and it cracks its skull wide open, blood, guts, brain matter, demony badness, the infernal hound is toast. Pardon my pun. The fist then, ducking and weaving, takes it, just starts taking, hauling ass towards the fucking throne, which, you know, McLeod, Spawn of Ava, is perfectly happy to just, like, sit here and funnel you guys, as best he can. Then it's Grizzly's turn.
I get up.
You roll what? You're only 1d10 damage.
Oh.
Because you're burning. You're acidy.
Oh.
Are we plowing through top of the hour, by the way?
Is it top of the hour?
Yeah. It's past top of the hour.
Okay, so that acid is eating through you right now as you're pushing up. That's half of your movement to stand up from prone. To find out what happens next.
That's 7.5.
Awkward. To find out what happens next. Gonna have to tune in 3 to 5 minutes. Stay tuned, don't touch that dial. We'll be right back after these messages. Who needs to mend the guns? I have to pee so bad.
I can stay this time.
I'm good too.
Alright, welcome back to twitch.tv/EvilSqueegee. I am Evil Squeegee, and I'm about to kill the shit out of somebody. It is worth noting, this won't make it to YouTube, but we did just give away a DMG, a PHP, and a monster manual. Because I was feeling generous. And now I really need to go do all those giveaways, and I've got like fucking 7 books to go. It's okay though, it's okay. It's okay, we got this, alright? We are on top of everything here. It is my time to shine, because it is the top of the round. Grizzly, you were about to charge up the stairs when you were riddled full of acidic, poisoned bullets. You failed all of your saving throws, and you ate all of the damage.
Mod running the sheet, 4 crits to Squeegee and a botch to each player from Robovin.
Alright, no, that's fair. He's got Destiny tokens to spend.
Wow, shite. Okay, so, Mr. DM.
Yes.
Mechanically, are the stairs difficult to aim?
Yes.
So, when it comes to 15 feet and you can only move 7.5, what does that mean?
Okay, I'm charging you one square of movement, because you have half speed, because you lost your leg in a previous adventure, right?
Yeah.
So, standing up from prone is supposed to eat half of your move speed. I'm gonna round down in this case, so half of your move speed is gonna be one of your three squares.
Okay. So that's fine. But I'm gonna dash. So... okay, like, with my normal movement, I can get...
One.
I'm guessing the...
That is difficult to raise.
That's it. Right?
So now you can dash 1, 2.
Okay. And there you go. And I fall for it.
You know you're putting yourself, like, outside of Lola's ability to put a potion down your throat.
I don't know if she's gone mad from my tech.
I'm suffering from...
Oh, yeah, because your madness. All right, so that is Grizzly's turn. Does it then make it my turn?
Oh, I rage because I'm getting super annoyed and falling over.
All right, so,
There's two HP you've got to get halved, okay?
All right,
no insta-kill for you.
I'm going to say that McCloud, seeing you acid-ing yourself up, he's just going to leave you to burn.
You motherfucker.
and he gets a hex and a hax shot. His two is two demonically modified steampunk guns. I'm gonna say the fist and Hawthorne in that order. The fist! Does 22 hit you?
Hold on. You have
disadvantage.
Do you have any stuffs?
You have disadvantage because I'm dodging.
I do! You did spend a dodge.
You have crits. You have crits.
No, you crits.
I thought I used one.
No,
I crit.
Gigi has crit.
Okay, so I'm going to say...
Gigi has crit.
Next, cool! Crit. All right, yeah. So crit me.
I have... How many... Oh, God, because multiple people. All right, so you're going to eat a crit.
Five in a row, yep. Yeah.
That's going to be... what the fuck is this? Oh, an extra D8. Five and seven...
Dread.
Five and seven poison.
So thank you, Dreadnought.
Thanks, Dread!
Can I get a DC 12 con saving throw from the fist?
There you go.
Oh, damn, you don't give a fuck.
Oh, damn.
Actually, Grizzly, I'm sorry, you should have gotten... Oh, no, that one doesn't actually have an end condition.
While poisoned, target can't regain hit points. The target can repeat the same throw at the end of its turn.
Yeah,
I can stop being poisoned.
Yeah, so you can stop the poison. You are also allowed to spend your action making a medicine check.
Yeah.
To stop the acid that's burning your flesh. But you dashed. Would you like to retract that dash?
No.
Okay. Because I would have let you, because I didn't announce that specifically. Okay, so that was the fist, and Hawthorne, you're going to eat a crit.
From Robo!
A crit from Robo, a crit. That's going to be another D8 on top of the 7. That'll be 14 poison damage and a DC 12 con check.
Which I botched, thanks to Robo.
Alright, The DC for removing the poison on your medicine check is going to be higher.
Oh, I'm poisoned?
Yeah, you ate the one with the D10 every round. You're not poisoned disadvantage. You're poisoned not disadvantage. You're poisoned damage.
Did we say that if I get dropped below half, that's when I have to make checks for...
Yes! So roll me a DC 15 wisdom save because you are starting to frenzy.
Yeah, sorry about this.
I gotta have another TPK.
Yup!
So that's a failed wisdom save, so...
You're
I believe that means I...
Move towards, you move towards a target of Destiny Token Origin.
Yeah.
Okay, so your next action...
So
okay,
my...
Here's what I wanna do. This is on my turn, right? So you're gonna shift. Then on your turn... You can roll save to control yourself during shift, but you have to shift.
Yep, that's fine.
That is going to make you drop your guns.
Yep, that's fine.
Okay, so the spray of bullets, he just kind of like boom, 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 right? All the, and you can see, like, the bullets kind of, like, ricocheting off the stone floor, and acid splashes and poison clouds just kind of, like, as the bullet marks just kind of, like, trail a line between the fist and Hawthorne, right? And he hits them both. You guys are getting really fucked up here as McCloud is just unleashing, right? Hawthorne, that bullet rips through your leg, and you get so angry, and the werewolf in you will take over.
I'm so sorry. Look who's right next to me.
Is this not the right fucking token? Hold on.
Are you trying to do my thing?
Yes. Hold on, I need to find this token.
Is it? No, it doesn't have the shift thing on it.
Yeah, okay, so I'm fixing that now. Because we have a very special,
supposed for the record, if I hadn't have had those temporary hit points, I'd be down right now.
Don't you deal yourself damage to make awesome things happen with your guns, too?
That's already included in my total thus far. So until I cancel it, then I basically have a reduced hit point total. So that's still in effect. It just applies to my claw damage now.
Now, as I was saying, God damn it. This shit I go through. Make this stuff awesome. You shift. You are now a fucking werewolf. Your guns drop to the ground on either side of you. Okay? You are large. I don't know why this character won't stick to the grid, but stick to the intersections.
Yeah, I can alt move. Yeah, I can alt move stuff. It's fine.
And on your next turn, you will get a DC 15 wisdom save to not move to the closest target and attack it. If you pass that wisdom save, you will get to keep your turn. Also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 30. Lola! Another hellhound!
Why do they like me so much?
Because if I attack somebody else, everybody would die.
That's true!
There we go. Here's the hellhound. He's gonna take his bite. Does an 11 hit you?
I botched because Robo.
No, you're not rolling.
What's your AC? What's your AC?
I thought I was having to. Never mind.
No, he misses! There is hope! All right. So that is the bad guy's turn. The party now gets to go.
I have a question. Do I not get my dex bonus on a chain shirt? On my AC?
You should.
Okay, that's fine. I can make sure I just.
The fist sprints up from her position below to instead be in melee range of our friend here.
Yep.
I'm going to punch this person, but I get a botch for that, so
I miss.
Thanks, Robert.
But I spend a key point and I flurry, so I get two more hits.
Okay.
Yeah!
Oh, one of them crits!
Oh, shit.
Does an 18 hit?
An 18 does, in fact, hit McCloud, yes.
Okay, so 5... and 9. Oh. So, 14 damage. As I pummel him into the ground.
Does he have resistance to fist?
No, but no one in the world has resistance to fist.
That's brilliant.
No demon, no angel, no creature of land or sea can resist my mighty punches.
That was you're spending your second beat of 3, I think, total, right?
Yeah.
Okay, for the charge. Yeah. Okay, so he does in fact have resistance to damage from fists. It counts as bludgeoning. That's gonna be, how much is that? That was, you said it was 14?
Yeah.
Okay, so he's gonna take 7. and you botch your first swing. So what's gonna happen, right, is you're gonna come in, okay, and basically, you come in and you come like running up the stairs. You come jumping up because you've also got to go on top of the giant's throne. This was the throne that the giant king ruled from, right? And you come sailing up, like vaulting up off this floor, and you come crashing down with your foot, right? But that foot misses, and he grabs it. He drops a gun and just snatches. He's gonna get a free grapple on you, and then you just pow, pow!
Sure, right, grapple me as much as I want. All I want is a hug so I can punch you more.
Oh, on his next turn, he's going to try throwing you.
Which gun did he drop?
He dropped the acid damage gun.
Oh yeah, Grizzly likes guns.
I meant to ask, am I out of range of Grizzly now?
Yeah.
You have disadvantage.
And what exactly
yes.
does that do to me again?
That means you have disadvantage on all of your rolls.
Okay.
All right. So that is the bad guys. That is the Fist, Hawthorne, and Lola. Lola, would you like to take your turn first?
Oh God. I'm gonna. I guess I have to try to attack the one that's right in front of me. I'm going to shoot it, because I don't trust my magic right now.
You will have disadvantage, because it is
in
melee range.
Yeah, and I botch, because Robo.
Alright, the gun jams. Seems okay. The simplest way to resolve a botch. So you go to shoot this devil hound that is right in your face, and you go to pull the trigger and fuck.
This is why I don't like technology, and I'm just gonna throw the gun at this point.
I get another wisdom save, right?
Yes. Would you like to spend DC. Would you like to spend your last bit of inspiration?
I already spent it.
Oh no, DC 15. Oh! You get full control of yourself.
That's actually not a bad thing.
It is, however, the right top now. Of your turn, and you are acided. However, you are shapeshifted, so you take half. So you're gonna take one half. Take four. Do you have any potions left over from previous adventures?
Nope. I gave my only potion, which was... did we have a potion before? And I just didn't record it?
We weren't given any for this one. Then.
No, you weren't given
we weren't given any now, but did the Templar give us one to go in? Because if so, I don't have it on my sheet.
No, they didn't.
Okay, then I'm on...
Oh, wait, no, from the last adventure you went on?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we did
Everybody got two potions.
Oh, well, then I have two potions.
Well, isn't that fucking handy?
Yes.
Oh, really?
I'm gonna drink one
bonus,
which was, and then I'm gonna go to town on this fucking dog.
All right. Really? Well, heal for four, and I'm gonna rule that you don't need to spend a medicine check to remove the acid.
Okay, I'm fine with that.
I'll let the potion basically eat the acid. So lose four, gain four. And then roll me your main attack. You don't get an offhand because you quaffed a potion.
Yep.
A 13 will hit.
Okay. Oh shit, I didn't transfer my hex, but I still do that as well.
You also get the basic claw damage as well.
Yep.
7 damage.
Well, 8. 5-3.
Yes, I'm good at math.
It's okay. I got you, dude. I got you.
Math adding the difficulties. All right, so the werewolf keeps control. Now, this is going to happen every time you take damage, by the way. You got to make that save. All right. For now, you keep control, and you just come barreling down on this motherfucker with hands, with claws moving faster than the human eye or the orcish eye can track and just start tearing flesh off this thing. Lola, meanwhile, your gun is jamming and you're throwing it aside, being like, fuck! Right? The Fist is in grapple with McCloud, spawn of Ava. But Grizzly, it is your turn. Roll me 1d10.
Yep, fuck.
If you roll a three or less. If you roll a three or under on this 1d10, you stay conscious.
Oh!
Wow!
Oh! Oh! You take one damage.
Did it.
Nailed it, dude. Nailed it.
Wow. Shit.
What do you do, Grizzly? What do you do?
I stand up.
Okay. I will. If you want to close to melee, you can close to melee.
I'll do it then.
All right, what is your
action? Reckless attack.
You get a
reckless attack this guy with my great axe. Because, you know, now it's just a normal roll.
All right, roll me an attack with a great axe. That hits.
No, wait. No, wait. It butches because of Roadbook.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. So, I'm going to let McCloud take his action now instead of later.
Shit.
Okay. McCloud, spawn of Ava, is going to beat a motherfucker with another motherfucker.
Oh, God.
He's going to try.
He's going to crit thanks to Pyro.
Would you say that the fist counts as a maul for damage dice purposes?
Oh my god.
This is a dwarf. She's not really that big.
Alright, a mace, perhaps?
Isn't there rules for, like, unconventional weapons or something?
Yeah.
Not that I am aware of.
An improvised weapon. I mean...
I don't see it on the damage chart.
Improvised weapons. Sometimes characters don't have their weapons to attack with. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Does it say damage? Oh, no, it just says 1d4.
Alright, well, fine. I'll crit you for 1d4. Plus strength. This is going to be a 2d4 plus 3.
I'm down!
Okay, so, Grizzly!
Fuck you.
Grizzly, Grizzly. You know what this means? This means it's time for a lingering injury. You lose an eye!
Fuck's sake!
You lose an eye!
Wow.
You're just slowly losing all your body parts! This is not good!
These dice do not like you, bro!
Alright, oh, man.
So this will also cost McCloud his grapple on the fist. Because you're like, and you come in, right? But as you're coming in, McCloud just looks up and says, I swore I would kill you. And using his grip on the fist ankle, just fucking whoops it as he fucking clocks you right upside the fucking head. Blam! Thud, right? And something about the fist's amazing, diamond-like, well-trained, battle-hardened fist is just like, out goes your eye.
They're amazing and diamond-like, wow. But this guy still has resistance. You can't resist the fist.
So Grizzly, you are down, and that is a death save.
Now or next turn, since my turn was
set? Next turn.
Cool.
Next turn, you'll make a death save.
Oh my god.
The fist.
Next turn!
You'll get, like, clocked in like, what? But because you're a fucking monk, as he loses his grip on you from the swing, right, you're basically gonna land, like, in one of those fucking awesome crane poses, except for with more fist.
Always.
More fisting going on, right? Okay, so, that is Grizzly's turn, right? Then go the bad guys, but I spent him, so my Hellhound goes, correct?
Yep.
Hey, Lola.
You
nom,
crit.
Nom, 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 nom.
Stop
crit.
Reminding him of these things!
Have to, man. Have to.
11 plus 1d8 is 17 damage.
I'm down.
Well then.
Hey, Lola!
What?
On a 15?
Wow.
You get a festering wound. You have one level of exhaustion that cannot be cured without, like, actual medical attention or Templar help or something. Exhaustion means if I ask you for any ability check that is not an attack roll or a saving throw, you have disadvantage. Because this,
okay.
As, like, the hellhound comes and bites, right, and tears open a wound in your leg, you pass out, right? And the dust and dirt of being in the manor infects your wound.
Okay. I'm also on disadvantage because Grizzly is way the hell away too, right?
Luckily for you, disadvantage yeah. doesn't stack.
Oh, that's good.
I only count it for stacking for the purposes of using advantage to cancel disadvantage.
Yeah.
So with two levels of disadvantage, the only difference is that you have to spend two levels of advantage somehow to get a normal roll.
I can't seem to get my token to say zero health points for some reason. Or hit points.
It says zero HP.
It looks like it. It says it's zero. Fine. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so that is the bad guys, then goes the PCs. Hawthorne?
Oh, good God.
You can make a full round of attacks on this hellhound.
How healthy is it looking?
That's this hellhound. Fuck that thing. It's in the way. It's on a scale of ow to ugh, it's more like ugh.
Unlike Grizzly and Lola, who are more on the ugh side of things.
Right.
Yeah.
It is definitely wounded. It is definitely wounded. You took a big chunk out of it last time.
Right. Okay, I'm going to hit it once to begin with, see how it goes.
All right.
I'm very close to just fucking going, by the way.
Yeah. That'll hit. Roll me damage. And Crimson Rite damage.
Yep.
So that'll be a total of 7.
Yep.
Another hit like that, and it will die.
For the record,
you rolled 2s on both of those damage dice, right? Yeah, so if you give me another average hit, it'll die. If you're under average, it'll live.
Right, fuck it.
Hit.
I think nice. That's...
You down it.
That's it.
You did it. Yeah, no. You leave it at -1, motherfucker.
Now for the real problem.
Well, the real problem is that shit's dead down south, pretty much.
I mean, I'm alive.
I know.
The fist endures.
The question is, do you think that you could survive this? You've identified what you came in here for was Ava's trap, right?
This is the... I still have movement, right?
Yes.
Okay. Can I forgo my movement and put a... in fact, you know what?
Can you forgo your movement and put a what?
Can I drag Lola over this way out of line of sight? With
I will allow you
movement?
To drag Lola out of line of sight as part of your movement.
Oh,
I'm
thank
charge
you.
You. That brings us to the top of the round, doesn't it?
I'm going to move myself back in the room so I can see.
I haven't punched anything yet.
All right. But yeah, the fist hasn't gone yet.
Oh, fist! Go ahead!
So I'm pretty much going to be like, this ain't going well. I ain't sure we're going to make it. I'm getting Lola out of here.
Getting in the face of this other dwarf with half a face, I say, you still have a chance to give up. The fist will listen to your pleas of mercy. And then come on.
All right, the 20 will hit, the 9 will not.
4.
All right, do you have any key left to spend?
Nope.
Did you take a short rest before we came in, or did you just...
Oh, I did, yeah. No, I did have key points. I will take a key point to patient defense, which gives me dodge. So, disadvantage to you.
Out of character, do I have a crit lined up?
You have a crit, then a nat, then a crit, then a nat, then a crit.
You have disadvantage. If it's a crit, it's still
crit
disadvantage.
Overruled, yeah.
Yeah, but unnatural crits are a bit.
The unnatural, unnatural crits.
We don't roll dice for the crits.
I stand here and I punch you again.
Okay. Have you got like a? never mind.
Five.
Nice.
All right. And that'll be how much damage?
Nine.
Okay, accounting for that. Boom. All right, so he is actually starting to look a little slapped around.
That's what happens when you fight the fist.
And Hawthorne, did you say you were moving back in or no?
I've pulled her out. I basically want to put this other potion down her throat.
Okay.
Before going back in.
She's the
only person that I know from a previous thing. And I once thought she was my mother.
I was going to say I was his mom.
So right. I'm thinking, like, with all this madness, ghost bullshit, hallucination shit going on, like, some of that instinctual nature is going to apply.
All right, that'll be a beat for the fist. Remember those healing potions, Lola. You stand back up. You're outside of the room. And
how much health do I get back?
2d4 plus 2.
2d4, right?
2d4.
Oh, yeah, you've got it. Okay, cool.
I got it. 2d4 plus 2. It's going to be... You're going to wake up with 9 HP. And you can also then decide, fuck it, I'm going to step in here around the corner and fucking scorching rid the shit out of this bitch if you would like.
It'll reach from there?
Yes.
Oh, then yes.
You are a walking nuke. That is your job. And because you didn't take actions this round, you can reach this corner, Scorching Ray, and actually move back, even with half speed.
I will like to do that, and I will spend my inspiration to do so.
All right. Give me 3 Scorching Ray attacks. The first one has advantage.
The 13s, though.
They all hit.
Wow.
Oh, nice.
Give me damage for each Scorching Ray. There's no strength save involved. 7, 11, and 9.
Yeah, that's some weird fucking hell.
That's 27, right?
Yep.
Oh my god, he has 9 HP left.
And I'm gonna back out because
You can go about that far. Yeah. Okay, so Grizzly.
It's a question, Mr. DM.
Yep.
I'm acid, right?
Yes.
Does that give me an auto fail on death save?
Yes, because you didn't spend the action to cure it.
Oh, shit!
Okay, so now I'll give you a death save.
So
can I spend inspiration death save to get advantage?
Can
I inspiration when I'm dead?
Yeah, you can spend inspiration, but I let players spend inspiration on death saves all the time.
Yep.
So just hit the death save button twice.
Well, shit.
Fail anyways.
Oh shit.
So you're failed, and you're failed.
Yep.
Now my bad guy goes.
Wait, I have a quick question.
Yep.
Was I supposed to get any sort of disadvantage on that roll because I wasn't near Grizzly?
Don't worry about it.
No? Okay.
You were supposed to, but we're not panicked about it. Yeah. Okay. Now, under normal circumstances, I would call this a bitch move. And I generally, as the GM, just let monsters not attack people or down. But,
Do it, you motherfucker!
My bad guy is gonna spend his action pointing his gun point blank. Is this a crit?
It doesn't matter.
You have a crit. Yep, you have a crit thanks
right,
to
how'd you kill me?
Robo. Robo has actually killed someone with a crit. There you go.
Wait, he hasn't killed anybody with a crit yet?
Not directly, no.
Not
all right.
Today.
So wow. So McCloud turns to you and pulls the trigger on his gun, right? And you are going to go sailing off headless, backflipping in a spray of blood and just splatter all the way down. I only did this because I knew for a fact you were cool with dying. And this this gives the fist a chance. This gives the fist a chance.
The fist never backs down.
All right.
The fist always punches. Is it our turn?
It is now your turn, because
I punch!
You punch!
There's three punches.
Oh, I thought she said botch. I was like, no.
All right.
She does botch the first one.
The first one is a botch. All right. So give me the second two damage rolls.
I just saw that.
So it would be 9 total.
Did I not just say he had 9 damage?
Yeah, except you also said he had damage resistance.
That's right. Okay, so he's gonna have 4 HP left. All right. So you are going berserk. Do you have any particular the fisty ways that you would like to?
The fist fights like a boxer meets a professional wrestler. So just think of it that way. I can't really describe it any better than that, but it's like that.
Pyrotechnics is basically what I'm getting out of this.
There is showmanship involved in the fist punching people.
All right, and as a botch, same thing I said last time. You're gonna finish this in like the wrestle grapple. All right, this will in turn cost him his gun as it did last time. All right, and he's gonna try and throw you on his next action. However, that is the fist. All right, Hawthorne.
I'm gonna step out.
Yep.
I'm gonna transfer my hex to him.
That's a bonus action.
Yep, and I'm gonna cast Eldritch Blast.
Oh, I forgot you had the blood magic spell. I was like, why don't you spend your bonus action picking up the gun? Roll it. It boils down to this.
You hit the fist.
Oh no! No, I don't wanna pick this up. I'm gonna say
I don't want to say
Eldritch Blast is not a good thing in Everdeep. Like every single one hits.
There's so many mods, so many mods.
Yep.
Alright, Hawthorne. Instead of hitting the fist, because I really wanna give this the chance, at the end of the fist's next turn, that's where I'm like, yeah, I've stretched this out enough, alright? Take the force damage from your own Eldritch Blast.
Yeah, I was just gonna say I could just straight up take the damage myself.
Does he frenzy from his own damage?
Backfire.
Roll me a will save.
Oh, hang on. Let me see if I'm conscious. So, I am conscious. Just.
It could be a DC 15 will save.
And then... Oh, shit. So... On my next turn, I'm going to be making moves towards Lola.
Lola, I might recommend you fucking either. Okay, so Lola, here's the deal, okay? You can, I think you have a second level spell slot left, you can attempt another Scorching Ray. Or you can run. He only has 4 HP left.
You're getting 3 attacks. With disadvantage, you should hit 1.
You say that!
why would you jinx it, Zagmag?
But, okay, so here's the question, though. If I get the Scorching Ray off and I kill him, isn't Hawthorne still going to kill Lola?
I don't think I can actually kill you.
Yeah.
Basically, his next action is to move in and attack. I suppose you could come in, Scorching Ray, and spend the rest of your movement speed running away. Hawthorne would then come in, make an attack, probably drop you, but he can't kill you.
Okay.
Is Pyro saying you should botch the next 3 rolls? Or is he like, I don't know what he's saying.
Go ahead and make me the roll, Lola.
Alright, I'ma do this. I'm not gonna run.
Okay, just before he says to spend those tokens.
No, just make you, the roll.
Yes.
Hit. No, I'm sorry. Hit, miss. Miss. Roll me damage. Oh, he has no fire resistance!
Ha!
Okay. Now move away.
Fast.
Move out of the way.
You can move up to 3 squares back. All right. Woo! Hawthorne.
Yeah, that you want that claw attack, right?
Move it and swing, yeah.
So I'll just take the swing as she's running past me.
No, you have to move to her and attack. You're not making an attack of opportunity.
Oh, okay.
There's a difference. That's why I advise her to move away. Because,
okay.
Because you're not required to make
it. So it hits?
Yep, roll me damage.
Crimson right.
Oh, God.
I'm sorry.
Doesn't matter, he can't drop her.
7.
She takes 7. Lola, you're up. You gain control of yourself. It's only for that one attack. You don't have to repeat the process.
Yeah, yep.
All right.
Yep.
So your rage, you can't see what's going on. You move in, you swing.
He won't stop me finding my mother.
You punch him so much. You're so focused on your wrestling match, right? And you start squeezing, and then you squeeze, and he explodes! Literally! Bits and pieces of him fire everywhere! It would seem Fist defeated a worthy foe.
Always. Always.
Poor Grizzly. Bit of a very poor Fist.
as this dwarf explodes in fire and goblets of gore, the Fist turns around towards the party as he explodes, and there's like this explosion behind her of like dwarf, and it's like meat chunks sort of like pelt the back of her, but she stands firm and she goes, "Easy."
And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Everdeep.